करुणाकर सूरीन्द्र गुरुवर्य पदाम्बुजाम नवनीत नटोत्तम साम गुरु पंक्ति श्रीयन्नुमः। द स्टोरी ऑफ नडादूर अम्माल। नडादूर अम्माल इज अ फेमस श्री वैष्णव आचार्य हु वॉज नोन टू बी द ग्रैंड प्रिसेप्टर और प्राचार्य ऑफ स्वामी वेदांत देशिका। नडादूर अम्माल वॉज द ग्रैंडसन ऑफ नडादूर आल्वान हु वॉज द नेफ्यू ऑफ भगवद रामानुजा। स्वामी रामानुजा हैड टू सिस्टर्स नेमली कमला एंड भूमि एंड द सन ऑफ कमला वॉज द ग्रेट वरद विष्णु और नडादूर आल्वान। नडादूर आल्वान had a son named Devaraja Mahadeshikan who was blessed with a great scion of the Srivatsa clan who came to be called as Nadadur Ammal later. When Shri Nadadur Ammal incarnated as the son of Devaraja Mahadeshikan, he was called as Varada and later on came to be popularly known as Varada Guru. Varada Guru was born on a full moon day of the month of Chitra when the prevailing star was also Chitra. Some researchers say that this time period when he was born corresponded to 1165 AD and the Tamil year was Parthiva. Varadaguru was well trained by his erudite father in all faculties and the father decided to teach Shri Bhashyam to his son. On an auspicious day, Devaraja Mahadeshikan commenced the teaching with the invocation of the text which begins with the words Akhila Bhuvana. The young Varada stopped his father with a question. Why should Swami Ramanuja choose the word Akhila? He could have instead chosen words like Sakala or Nikhila, which would denote the same meaning. The happy and surprised father answered to his son that Swami Ramanuja's choice of this word was because he wanted to have the first letter of the text indicating the first letter amongst letters which denotes Lord Sriman Narayana. This incident also made Devaraja decide that he should be sending his intelligent boy to a preceptor who can train him well and who would have enough strength to appease his intellectual hunger. So he decided to send Varada to Engal Alvan of Thiruvellarai. Engal Alvan was called so by Ramanuja himself and this name was given to him by the Acharya because he had developed great fondness for this disciple. Engal Alvan was sought by Varada as his master. An interesting episode between the master and the disciple is narrated in Guru Parampara stories. At Thiruvellarai, Varadaguru found where Engal Alvan's residence was and he tapped at the door. Engal Alvan asked, "Who is that?" The student replied, "I am Varada, the son of Kanchi Devaraja Mahadeshika." The teacher replied, "Whosoever it may be, please come after I die." Now, what is the meaning of this? What is the use of going to somebody after he dies? The perplexed Varada returned home and asked his father. The father explained that the word I denotes ego or ahankara, and the teacher had only asked him to shed off his ego and then approach him. Moreover, in the Sri Vaishnava tradition, there is no I or me. In Tamil, it is called as Naan, Yenadu. Instead, Sri Vaishnavas use the beautiful word named Adiyen. Varada realized his mistake, prostrated before his father and reached Tiruvellarai again. This time, he knocked at the door and said, "It is Adiyen Varada who is here." Engalalvan became very happy and adopted him not only as his disciple but also like a beloved son. Both of them travelled together and worshipped the archa forms in many temples and finally reached Srivilliputtur. Engalalvan wrote a commentary to the Vishnu Puranam and in course of time reached Paramapadam. As an obedient son would, Varada performed the last rites of Engalalvan and installed an archa vigraha of Engalalvan at Tiruvellarai, which can still be seen today. He had great acharya bhakti and decided to follow his acharya's footsteps in propagating the Sri Bhashya. He returned back to Kanchi and began his Sri Bhashya teaching near the Kachchi Vaitan Mandapam, which is in the eastern side of the temple Sanctum Sanctorum. He chose this spot because this was the place where the Lord himself sowed the seeds of Sri Bhashya by answering 6 questions postulated to him by Sri Ramanuja through Tirukkachchi Nambigal, which is also famously known as the Aaru Vaarthai. Varada Guru made several pilgrimages and he won many debates, which included opponents from the Chola kingdom, the kingdom of Kashi and Setu. The Kashi king honored him by placing him on the Sharada Peetha. Varada Guru composed the Heti Pungava Stavam and saved a possessed Brahmin by invoking Lord Sudarshana. After many pilgrimages, he returned to Kanchi and continued with his Sri Bhashya Kalakshepams. His sweet rendering and excellent delivery of discourses attracted many disciples like Appular, that is Atreya Ramanuja, Vadakku Thiruvidhi Pillai, and Sudarshana Suri, the great grandson of Kurathalvan. Once, Varada Guru and his disciples undertook a pilgrimage to Tirumala Hills. Their graceful personality and behavior attracted the respect of all. Kandavaran, the leader of the Lada race, was annoyed and irritated to see them and their popularity, so he decided to disturb them. With his mantric powers, he made the disciples of Varada Guru unconscious. Varada Guru meditated and chanted the Sudarshana mantra and his own composition, the Heti Pungava Stavam, and broke the spell. The angry Kandavaran called Varada Guru for a debate, and at the end of it, he lost the debate and finally surrendered himself to the Acharya. The benevolent Varada Guru not only excused him, but also made him a Sri Vaishnava by offering Pancha Samskaram. With the money offered by Kandavaran, Varada Guru established a beautiful village and named it as Lada Graharam or Ladavaram. After that, he continued on his journey with his disciples. On the way, the Lord himself came as a young brahmachari and appeased the hunger of Varada Guru's disciples with curd rice. This was because they were traveling for a long time and had run out of provisions. So the Lord couldn't bear to see his devotees in hunger and came down to offer curd rice all by himself.
At this time, there was a big commotion at the Tirupati temple because the silver vessel in which prasadam is offered generally had suddenly disappeared. Then Lord Venkateshwara himself announced to the temple authorities that he himself had gone down and fed his dear Varada Guru and his disciples so that they could be energetic and comfortable to reach Tirumala to have his darshan. Varada Guru was deeply devoted to Lord Varadaraja. One night, when he was worshipping the deity in an ecstatic mood, the priest brought very hot milk to the Lord for Nivedanam. Varada Guru was deeply distressed that such hot milk would burn the tender tongue of the Lord. He stopped the priest from offering the hot milk and began cooling it down until it was warm enough to be drunk by the Lord. The Lord was moved by this vatsalya of Varada and called him as Amma, which means mother in Tamil. From then onwards, Varada Guru became Nadadur Ammal. After this episode, in a dream one night, Lord Varadaraja commanded Ammal to erect a mantapam for his Vasantotsava. Accordingly, Ammal fulfilled the Lord's desire just as a mother would fulfill the wishes of her son despite difficulties. Nadadur Ammal had many disciples and all of them would listen to his lectures attentively and would question him to understand concepts better. Their learned master gave them beautiful clarifications for all their questions. Sudarshana Suri, the grandson of Kurathalwar, alone would remain quiet because people thought he had no questions to ask. His mates discarded him as a dud. One day, as usual, the students had all assembled in the lecture hall. But the teacher was not willing to begin the lecture since Sudarshana Suri had not turned up. The other students requested Ammal to start the discourse, saying that the presence or absence of people like Sudarshana Suri really doesn't matter, because apparently he would never open his mouth for any discussion during any of the classes. Nadadur Ammal regretted to hear these words and he wanted to show his other disciples the worth of Sudarshana Suri. So, during the course of that day's lecture, Sudarshana Suri turned up a little late. The teacher asked him to sit down and asked him to explain the meaning of a simple phrase which he was teaching then. To everyone's surprise, Sudarshana Suri not only gave the literal meaning of the phrase, but also in-depth meanings of that little phrase, some of which had not even been understood by many disciples present there. This was very much to the pleasure of Nadadur Ammal, and he told the other students that any devotee should not be considered as a dud or any less than themselves. Sudarshana Suri then submitted to his teacher that he had a habit of scribing the content of every discourse that he had heard every night on palm leaves, and this compilation he presented to Nadadur Ammal at this time. This compilation came to be known as the Shruta Prakashika. The Shruta Prakashika is a revered grantham in Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya. Nadadur Ammal continued his Sri Bhashya Pravachanam even at the ripe old age of 100. Once, one of his disciples, that is Athareya Ramanuja or Appular, was to come and attend his Kalakshepam, but had got a little late since he had gone to visit his sister Totarambha at Tuppal. Totarambha had an illustrious son who was known as Venkatanatha and was 5 years old then. As Appular visited Totarambha, the child Venkatanatha insisted that he also wanted to accompany Appular to the Kalakshepam of Nadadur Ammar. Appular took the child along and reached the place of the Kalakshepam. At that time, Nadadur Ammar was lecturing on the Shri Bhashyam, referring to a portion which emphasizes on the importance of Vishnu Puranam. He was explaining the greatness of the author of Vishnu Puranam, that is Sage Parashara, and the opening phrase of the hymn which he explained spelt Padai Parashara Sattam. At this time, Appular and Venkatanatha prostrated before the assembly. Varada Guru stopped his discourse abruptly when Appular and his nephew prostrated before them. He was attracted by the Brahma Tejas of the child. On inquiry, Appular told him that the child was his sister's son and was born after his sister's pilgrimage to Tirumala Hills when she dreamt of swallowing the big bell of the temple. No wonder the child had a divine look. Ammal blessed the child and tried to pick up the discourse from where it had stopped. But that day, very surprisingly, he could not remember where he had stopped. Not only him, but every other person in that assembly did not remember the place where Ammal had stopped the Kalakshepam. To everybody's surprise, little Venkatanatha prattled the Prakrit phrase Padai Parashara Sattam and reminded the Acharya as to where he had stopped. Ammal's joy knew no bounds as he understood that the child was indeed an incarnation. He called child Venkatanatha, seated him on his lap and blessed him with all his heart, saying, Pratishthapita Vedanta Pratikshipta Bahirmataha Bhuyas Traividya Manyasvam Bhuri Kalyana Bhajanam. It is this grace of Nadadur Ammal which made this Venkatanatha into the great Vedanta Deshika. And this has been acknowledged by Swami Deshikan repeatedly in many of his works like Adhikarana Saravali, Tattva Mukta Kalapam, Nyaya Siddhanjanam and Tattva Tika. In fact, the same shloka with which Ammal blessed Swami Deshikan has been included by Swami Deshikan in his play called The Sankalpa Suryodayam. It is also recorded by Swami Deshikan's son in the Mangalam devoted to Vedanta Deshika. Nadadur Ammal was a great devotee and also a scholar beyond parallel. He has scribed a number of works which include the Tattva Saram, Prapanna Parijatam, Prameya Mala, Anika Chudamani, Aradhana Kramam, Prameya Saram, Mangala Shasanam, Jnana Saram, Jayanti Nirupanam, Heti Pungavastavam, Rahasya Sangraham, Chaturlakshana Sangraham, Paratattva Nirnayam, Dramidopanishad Sangraham, Shri Bhashya Sangraham, Paramartha Shloka Dvayam, Paratvadi Panchakam, Yatilinga Samarthanam. After a long life of 110 years, Shri Nadadur Ammal departed to Paramapadam on Shukla Paksha Panchami of the month of Masi. Nadadur Ammal had 4 sons, that is Varada Vishnu, Devaraja, Sudarshanar and Hetishar. His grand disciple is Swami Vedanta Deshika himself, who carried on the torch that was lit by Nadadurammal. Let us all pray at the feet of Nadadurammal by reciting his Taniyan. Putrine chitachit pitra pautrine paramishthina snushavate jagan matra vatsyaya gurave namaha.